Okay, good afternoon. So today I will solve one question. This question number 15. So here what is telling, the given equation is ax cube plus 3bx square plus 3cx plus d is equal to 0. Okay. And the three roots are the distance from O to A, O to B and O to C. So all A, B, C, O, they are in straight line, and given that B is the middle point of AC, then we have to prove this. That means this AB is equal to the distance AB is equal to BC. So AB is equal to OA minus OB and BC is equal to OB minus OC. So that means it's telling indirectly that all the three roots are in arithmetic progression. That means R2 minus R1 is equal to R3 minus R2. So these are the things given. Okay. So let us try to solve it. So first of all, what I used to do, I used to change the directory. So here I will do all these things, but for this problem I will, rather than writing the commands again and again, I will write a script. So I am opening a blank script. Okay, I am saving it. Solution equation of question number 15. Like that something I given the name. So let us, here we will define the three roots are U, V, W, A, B, C, D. So U, V, W are the three roots. So now the given equation is, AX cube 3bx square 3cx d plus d is equal to 0. That is the equation. Okay. So that means sum of all the roots, that means u plus v plus w, that is equal to minus 3b by a. Am I right? Okay. But as this u, v and w that are in arithmetic progression, then u plus w is equal to 2v. So now here I am making a function f1 which is equal to u plus v plus w. Okay. Now I will substitute this value of f1. Okay, so substitute my value of f1 with u plus w by 2v. Okay, so now f2, so let us run it. What is f2? So it will come here, if you say it should come 3v. Sorry, here this W is capital. See, it's coming 3V. Now, that summation of this is equal to minus 3B by A. So, there I will solve and I will find out the value of V. I will store in F3. So, F3 is equal to solve F2 is equal to minus 3b by a, and I will find out the value of V. Okay, so basically this is the value of V. So let us see how it is, what it will come. Okay, so value of V is equal to minus B by A that I have obtained. Now the second thing is UV plus VW. I'll write here UV plus VW plus WU, that is equal to 3C by A. Am I right? Okay. So this can be written, I'm simplifying one step. So here I will write, here if I take common V, that is U plus W plus WU, it is coming like that. Okay, so now I will define another variable WU as L. Okay, now I am writing another equation F4, which is V into U plus W plus L. Okay, now I will substitute this value of U plus W by V. Okay, so what I will do, first I will substitute the value of U plus W by V, then V, then I will substitute the value of V. So first I will substitute the value of F4, where I will put the value of U plus W by V. Okay, I'll get something. Then this I'll again substitute. This value I'll substitute. Now, till we in terms of V and L, now I'll substitute the value of V by F3. Okay. So let us run it. What should come? What it should come? It is coming something like that. So now this value is basically is equal to minus 3C by A. So from there I will find out the value of L. So that is F6 is equal to solve F5 is equal to 3C by A. I will solve and I will find the value of L. So let us see what it is coming. Is it, this is the value. Minus B square by A square plus three AC by A square. So you can give one more command, you will learn. If I give pretty F6, what should come? You see, it is coming in like this form. Earlier it was like this, now it is coming. Earlier it was like this, now it is coming like this. It is b square minus 3ac by a square, something like that. Okay. First, I have shown you. So basically, this is the value of L. Value of L. Now, all the products of the root. Okay. So products of the root is U, V, W. That is equal to D by A. Am I right? It is D by A. Now here, this I have U and W. What I have defined, WU as L. So that means here V into L, that is equal to D by A. Okay. So now I will define a function which is F7, that is equal to V into L. Okay. Now what I will do, I will substitute the value of V here. So I am defining that is F8. So substitute F7, this V I will substitute by F3. Okay. So if I substitute that, it will be in terms of L. Now if I solve it, F9, if I solve it, F8, which is equal to D by A, and I am solving the value of L, basically this will give, this is also is the value of L. Okay. Let us see. Sorry. So you see, it is coming minus D by B. So here F6 and F9 both are the value of L. So now if I both are equal. So basically, F6 minus F9 is 0. So now I am giving a simplify command. It is F10 is equal to simplify F6 minus F9, then pretty F10. You see here what it is coming, this value, that means minus, it is coming D by D by B plus minus B square by this one is this one. So what I have to prove, this one. Okay. So now here, there is somewhere I have done a mistake. So here basically this value is 2V. u plus w is equal to 2v. So let us solve again. See, now it is coming d by b plus this one. Again, some minus I have. So this will be minus. This will be minus. Okay. And you see, now I got. Okay, let us. I'll remove this one. Simply, I'll see what is F10. You see, my F10 is equal to this one. Now if I, basically this F10 is equal to 0, correct? As F6 is equal to F9, so F6 minus F9 is equal to 0. So now if you multiply, multiply both sides by minus, so it is coming like this. So now if you multiply both the terms with, now I'll give one, expand b into a square into answer. So let us what you see, d a square minus 3abc plus 2b cube is equal to 0. You see, so a square d minus 3abc plus 2b cube. You see, a square d is 0. So that things is proven. Okay. So now I'll save it. Now I will go for the another part, that is the graphical solution. See, why this graphical solution is important? Because sometime if you get an equation, like we can take the question number 4. Okay, so your left hand side is a trigonometric equation and your right hand side is a simple linear equation. Okay, so how to solve this? Because it is difficult to solve, unless otherwise you can pre-process the equation. So in such case, the graphical solution is the best one. Okay, now you know pi by 2 is infinity, tan pi by 2 is infinity. So pi by 2 means around 3.14, means 1.5, around 1.6 something. So I'll restrict the limit of x by till say 1.5. okay, so x is equal to starting from 0, then I am giving the increment this one, and it will go up to 1.5. okay, 1.5 also, it is going towards very long. Let us go to till 1. Okay, so now my first function y1 is equal to tan x and my y2 is equal to 1.2 into x. Now I am giving the plot command x comma y1 comma x comma y2. If I give that, you see the two places, the both the curves. So this blue color is the, you can see it is the tan x, and this your pink color or whatever, the gray color I think. So that is the y is equal to 1.2x. So now one solution is at x is equal to 0, and another solution is where it is getting intersect. Okay, so this area, it is nearly I think x is equal to around 0.7. again it is crossing. So this is the, in this way we can do the graphical solution when I cannot convert the equation in an in a polynomial form, okay? So let us quickly solve one more problem. E to the power x is equal to 5x, and it's telling the solution will be nearer 0.2. So I will expand it till 0.5, okay? So x is equal to 0. So my first equation y1 is equal to e to the power x, and my y2 is equal to 5x. Now if I get the plot, you see somewhere here it is intersect. So what is the point? You see it is around 0.26. The solution is getting converged. So let us see how it is happening. So exp 0.26, this is the value, and 5 into 0.26. You see both are, so solution this one and this one are same nearly. So at point x is equal to 0.26, the solution is getting converged. So this is the series solution. You can try other problem. So you should have a basic knowledge about this kind of trigonometric equation. Otherwise, if I take the x in between somewhere, so I should understand where it may be, where in at what area, what location it may get converged. Otherwise, you can get it, but it will take more time. So you should have some idea, because e to the power x, after some time it is exponentially increasing, and at that time this 5x, y is equal to 5x, that equation it seems that it will be like it is like line parallel to, means same as x axis. So that time you may be confused. So that's why I'm telling the range of x should be selected based on the nature of the equation. Okay. So hope you understood. And once you'll be doing the more and more, you'll get more knowledge. So with this first chapter, I'm going to close. So this is the next, we will start the determinant and matrix, which is very important for an engineer. Okay, whatever you will be doing, it is very important. So that we will start in the next session. Thank you so much.